Day everybody, and welcome to Noob Gaming. We will be continuing onwards with our Forge God Sentinel build. For now we have selected Warpath and Void Wreath as fire damage at the moment. We will be seeing if this is going to work a little bit better out. My main goal is still to do a type of convert this, hopefully sometime in the future, into a shield build. But for now, I'm going to continue onwards with Warpath and Void Wreath, as it is actually one of the better of my builds. Okay, so last we were... Is it the divine area? I believe. And it's the divine era. Is extremely big. Oh. Oh. Wow. Okay. Interesting. Okay, we'll run outskirts. We'll be taking it from there. Okay, and we are loaded in. Let's see, tab. Okay. Up we go. Something which is very strange, which I haven't actually realized up until a little bit later earlier today, when we were playing, when I was actually live streaming my Primalist Totem build, is that totems actually scale via minions. It's such a weird way of scaling totems, because like when you play Path of Exile and all that, you get totem nodes in your skill tree, so you can't. Yeah. I was so used to the whole matter of the fact that totems are totems and not minions, but Last Epoch does it a little bit more differently, which is very strange. it makes things most probably a little bit easier at the end of the day, that you don't have to concentrate on a lot of different kinds of damages, maybe, I'm not sure, but it was a weird way to find out. Not fun to find it out fairly late in the game, only after I have specialized into the shaman skill, to hope and pray I'll be able to get better loot, but apparently I was wrong. I should have just went and got minion equipment. Oh, the Great College, I remember this. You have to first go back to the the ruined era to be able to actually access this. If I remember correctly. Wait. Go to the ruined air room. There we go, ruins of Walrein. Upwards. The wrong way. Okay, wasn't the that's up here, I believe. There is the door. Strange fact of this ruined college is you have to first get to where the city is in, where the city is not ruined. Basically, you first have to be in the divine era, and then from the divine era you are able to actually open the door for the ruined area, because the ruined area is actually in the future, technically speaking. So by opening the doors in the past, you will be able to open the door in the future, so that you can actually access and get what you are able to get, or the totem, or it's this unique key that you need to get to be able to open the doors in the divine era. Okay, so back. And then from here, Imperial era. Not divine, Imperial. And we're gonna go down here to Imperial Wavern. Walrein. And then we go into... that's back to the outskirts. I don't want to go back to the outskirts. Sorry about that. The sound of humps fleeing the upper levels can be heard above. Nope, 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 and definitely nope. Level 27. Manifest armor, ring of shields. Okay, I'm not going into this any further. I'm going into Forge Guard. Actually, I need to remember to respec this. Because I'm not doing throwing. Respect that and put that into resistances. Okay.
Stand down, the done.
One pump. Okay.
Yes. Yes. Stay safe. What do you want?
Okay, 31 base attack. Spike attack. Okay, let's see. Melee, critical strike chance, physical damage. Chance to ignite on hit. Prefix, melee critical fire damage. That's as bad. No forge potential anymore. Guess that's where you end. Oh well. Let's see. 45. Sorry. Just that's better. Aerobic also increased.
Yes? I see.
Yes.
Okay. Let's continue. Yeah. Alright, come on. Which way was I going again? I was going upwards. Mana per 3 seconds. While spending again mana every 3 seconds while wielding. That's gonna help. Okay. It's not nearly enough mana that I'm getting back. To remember which way I was actually heading. Area 10%, okay. I'm not really going to do. I'm not going to do that. That's not really going to help. So let's get the range of area a little bit bigger. So I'll go if between max distance, you can travel farther, avoid cleave, and it deals more damage. So yeah, I'll juggle in between these. Molten infusion stacks. Okay, something like that. So you can't enter from here. Interesting. Okay.
Stand down or die.
For me, boss, this guy really doesn't do a lot of damage. Shrine. Soul Warden, it's a road. Defend myself. Okay, let's get them all into one little circle and just whack, 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 whack. That'll make me actually just completely dizzy. Oh, that was close. Lightning resistance. 200% of maximum mana added as stun avoidance. Cast a small lightning explosion when you are stunned. Let's see how it works. Yeah, it's all right.
Do that.
spinny spinny. Just to make sure something. Okay. This really is one wonderful device, one wonderful skill, sorry. I guess that's worn off. Okay, so the Risen Lake. Oh, isn't this? Can I check something here quickly? Soulfire Bastion. What? Oh, this is from the other side. The corrupted lake. Weren't able to continue onwards here because there was a door. I wonder. Thank you. mastery level. Health. Okay, so how do I get there?
Do that. Stand down or die. I cannot do that.
Look at that light a little bit like that. They need to die of fire damage. So that's where we came in. There, that's where we came in. So. I feel like this is not the end. Oh, wait, did I not kill that thing earlier? Okay. Find the outcasts in the Risen Lake. Okay, so this doesn't go to there. That's just not right. Okay. I think I've cleared everything. you're really liking the collective, like, one or two of the same things.
I cannot do that.
areas are massive. Okay. Where's all the enemies? Looks like their own little village.
Welcome, traveler. Welcome, traveler.
Okay, that was fairly easy. One more ability that I get manifest armor. Actually, I really want to see how that skill looks like. Well, technically speaking, I should be able to go to the Fallen Woods to there. Let's see if we can. Just to say thanks, Zipto can Tipico, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. Sorry if it sounds like I'm butchering the name or not, but thanks for subscribing to my YouTube channel. It really means a lot. Thank you.
cannot do that.
Increase melee attack speed, increase movement speed. Ward gain melee hit chance per 20, ward to gain haste for 2 seconds. Elemental attacks deal 1% increased damage per 200 ward. This will actually be a very good This would actually be a fairly good weapon for a spellblade. Area. Let's see this manifest armor, see how it works. You deal increased melee damage if you're using two-handed weapons. Yes, I'm definitely going to do that. Damage taken by attackers when hit. Okay, so that's armor again. Bleed chance, ignite chance. Does not scale with points allocated. Also applies to minions, double for you with a two-handed weapon. What minion does minion tag? Manifest armor is a minion. Forge strike is also minion tagged. Oh snap! It's like a little. Okay. I did not know that. That is actually quite interesting. And that can actually play well with the shield bolt, because it's technically an armor. It's technically something that attacks. Okay. I'm definitely going to level that up. Okay, so before I head that way, let's go up top and explore the rest of the area. Maybe there's something I'm missing, like a boss or hidden chest or something. Not sure. I don't really have any other things that can actually go in there, so. This looks a lot like the forest. Very first forest. Yeah, that area where we spawn almost. Or just after that little village that you get. Attacking my own minion. The moment he's just there just to take the heat off of me. He has a lot of health. So, melee physical damage states equip shield. Manifest armor gains a shield which scales with the stats of your equipped shield. Interesting. Okay, health regenerate per second, increased effects. Gains a shield which scales with the stats of your equipped shield. That's not too bad. Damage reflected. Okay. Iron Grasp, Bladed Armor, Sharpened Metals, Melee, Armor, Shred Charms, Damage 25%, Maximum Health, minus 8, and Armor, minus 8. That's not really. Manifest Armor gains a sword, which scales with your equipped weapon stats. Okay. So we go up top. Arkwright Blast Forge. Stats from helmet. Million spellfire damage. Forge Breath. Forge Breath Ignite. Area. Whirlwind Strike. Manifest Armor gains the ability to use Whirlwind Strike, a spinning attack which hits all. This thing is actually fairly great. See, now when you do a full shield build, you can go ahead and speak into there to get the shield, and then you can speak into there to get the sword. I would say you go first for the shield, for the sword, and then after you've gotten the sword, because it's like 1, 3, 1. This is just a little bit of a horrible one, but this will increase the armor stats, the health regeneration, and the health, because you lose health and armor. So technically speaking, by going into both directions at the top, this should technically speaking be working. Vengeful Guardian. Okay. Luckily, I went actually a little bit more upwards. Block charge, block efficiency, gain the sword chance and kill at 5. Charges the person first. Increase gold damage. Increase minion gold damage. Yeah, well. Not really any of these things, because that's really not going to help me. Soul Fist. I believe that's like a unique shield for a. But that's legendary potential 1. Okay.
Living so far from one of the cities, be at ease. I have no desire to fight you. Even if I did, this would be no place for me to draw weapons. Some Imperial commanders are, how should I say, touchy about others acting in their territory. My friend running the Soulfire Bastion here, Kremorous, is particularly sensitive about this sort of thing. Which reminds me, I had a reason for striking up this conversation. Not that it hasn't been pleasant so far. You put a smile on my face if we undead weren't always grinning. Simply put, Chromerus has been experimenting with a new form of soul magic in there. Very interesting stuff. Could revolutionize how we process souls for power. Don't know the details myself, but it seems to entail using old flame magic to create something called soul embers. I hear they consume souls entirely, but the results more than make up for it. Unfortunately for Chromerus, my patron would not be very pleased by his success. And I happen to have met a living adventurer with a knack for slaying undead. Isn't that right? So what do you say? Barge in there in the name of the living, wreck up the place, and put Chromerus out of commission for a while. Now I even sweeten the deal a little. Bring me some of those soul embers he was experimenting with, and I'll see what I can trade you for them. Okay. I knew you living still had gray matter sloshing around up there for a reason. Best decision you've ever made. Feel. And when I say a bit, I mean he keeps an inferno stocked in that place. Not to mention the necrotic fires he's been experimenting with. The soul embers may be able to help you, though. Burn one of those soul embers up, and you may be able to protect yourself from the fires in there. Though from what I've seen, it only protects you from one type at a time. There, you'll figure it out. Oh, you're not the first living I've made this deal with. Here's to hoping you're the first one to meet me at the other end of this place. May the immortal Emperor smile on you.
Okay, so every single time I need a key. Each attempt in the dungeon requires a key. Dying or leaving through a portal fails this attempt. Okay. Not sure if I'm ready for this, but let's give this thing a bash. And I presume I do not have the key.
A living so far, be at ease. I have no desire. My friend, you put simply put. Unfortunately, so what is now I even sweeten the deal. And when burn one of those souls. Oh, you're not the first living I've made this deal with. Here's to hoping you're the first one to meet me at the other end of this place. May the immortal Emperor smile on you.
So I need a key. Now, where do I get the Soulfire Bastion key? Random drops. Great. End game or anywhere.
not do that.
Just got the Lightless Arbor, key on the Imperial Cragmoat and Act 4, so I guess anywhere. Okay, thanks. I think these keys are fairly easy to drop, so I think those things take time. Dead end.
I cannot do that.
again. I've got that. Increase the mana. I'm definitely gonna need to. That actually increases it. But my mana cost. Fury per second, that's actually fairly good with the mana cost. Plus 4. That minus is 2. That gives me 7 per second. So I'll have to go there, here, there. So yeah, so Dark Nexus, Unchained, and Warrior's Fury. That is the direction of what I'm going to go for. Yep, those three. Concentrate on those three until I reach max level. Sure what max level is for. Thank you. 31. Is there anything that helps with mana regen? Block, stun, health, armor. Just need to respect that point. This applies to minions. Really did not think that. Yo, that's just armor, that's damage and damage. So far I've just constantly got damage into
Unlucky?
Oh, I hope so. Use staff clave to end its spear, okay. I stole just a one-handed weapon.
Try.
Full plate, low force potential, that's fine if we've got the common 15 force potential.
Go again? Shame. So thing about luck, though. Hey, I don't run these games for free.
Yeah, I get that, but you've given me shit. Sorry for that. 16 forge potential. 1 to shield bash, increased melee damage. This one will work a little bit better. Rune of Discovery adds a random tier 1 affix to all empty affix slots on any item. That's actually fairly great. Rune of Removal. I'll do that with this maybe. Okay, so prefix fire damage. Cause I do fire damage, yeah. Ooh. Prefix mana regeneration. Freeze. Mana regeneration, please. Ay 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 ay. Suffix, please, 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 please. Physical resistance. Let's add necrotic. Oh, yeah. Health regeneration. Physical resistance. Avoid. Just gonna take a look at what I actually do need. Necrotic is the main one, yeah. And cold. No, lightning. The health regeneration is not. Let's go for lightning resistance. Can't upgrade any of these things, so that's a bust, but at least increase fire damage. 543 526. How is that possible? Increase the mana regeneration. It's more important at the moment. Increased mana by 8%, increased dodge. That I can maybe change as well. Unlock potential. Poison resistance, dexterity atonement, fire resistance. Mana. That helps. Poison the fire resistance, I'm not too bothered about. I'm really not too bothered about that. Okay. Attunement. Increased fire damage and ignite duration. Hallelujah. Okay. Clear that off. I can upgrade that mana. Upgrade the fire resistance and untier. Yeah. Can't do the mana. Okay. 587.
These items might be your best bet.
Oh, believe me, it helped me quite a lot. Okay, I'm just gonna make something to drink and I'll be back in a short while. Yay, and I'm back. Okay. Let's do this. Imperial area. Era. Touch writing, if you have been hit recently, increase writing for dexterity, increase movement speed, less damage taken while moving. Leather boots. It's more like for a rogue. My cold damage is my cold resistances needs to go up.
Okay.
close. We don't have lunge. I just use lunge for as a movement skill, that's about it. Nobody is online. Looks like everybody is sleeping.
I cannot do that.
Okay. Blessings. Oh, it's different things. Discover blessings. Stolen Wands, Ending the Storm, Fall of the Empire. Undiscover. How do you discover these blessings? That's interesting. There is so many things in this game that I still need to learn, and it is great. I haven't enjoyed myself so much of a game for a while. Did play Hogwarts Legacy for a little bit, but My laptop ain't that good to actually continue. I am able to play it because I'm actually need the minimum requirements, but it doesn't really. How can I say it? It's a fairly big game. I'm almost at the end of it, but this is a lot more fun than that, in my opinion. Wait, did my armor die? You can only have one armor at a time.
Ship will be your tomb.
Okay. If it will be my tomb, then.
The immortal empire shows no mercy. Get off my ship, mortal! Upon my body.
Arrgh. Okay.
These chains. You'll have to excuse me. Easy. The best time to learn is now. Get to the railing and give a signal when you're ready.
It is a wonder I didn't drown in my armor.
Okay, so we're still at the Imperial. Imperial era. Okay, so we were here. Now we're here.
Up safely. Good. I need you to see.
Problem is?
Yes. I'll hang back and I'll only slow you down. Please, go on without me.
I could not do that.
Okay. Yes, I. I can't enter there. This is probably again one of those things where you have to travel back and forth in between the times. Whoa.
Thank you.
Yeah. Need to increase this while spinning. You gain mana every 3 seconds while wielding a two-handed weapon. Fourteen. That helps. But two-handed weapon, yes. Grand Solar Idol increase Abyssal Decay. It really doesn't help, but we'll just add it in. That helps do something at least. Search the Wraith Dunes for signs. Okay, so that's near.
Cannot do that.
These things almost look like, if you look very fast, they look like those skull sheeps from the Nightshade. With that black cloak over them.
Yeah. cannot do that.
Close calls.
Too heavy.
Okay. Let's see. Chance to bleed on hit, 4 health on kill. Increase critical lightning, 16% of potions, cold damage, increase minion cold damage. Not going to use that. Comes to bleed is always a good thing. 4 health on kill.
Gold won't save you, but a blade might.
I should have. I should have used my portal. I still have. Yeah, it's good luck, littles. To confirm my equipment. I picked up new access, so increased physical damage, critical strike multiplier, increased stun chance. 6 health and kill. This is 56 strike multiplier, 161% chance, increased area for melee area skill. Wow. It really doesn't help. That's just sad.
Now, it's the Oracle's, the way the Oracle told me with-
Hey now, I've seen how you handle yourself.
Wait, what? Wow, that was very fast very quickly. Can't I have that scythe? Okay, I'm gonna need to get more. I No, that will rule out the armor completely, what I've lost, and give me some more. Jo, ta jedna z... Keeps killing me.
Do that.
upper levels. I've got actually about it. I've got 2 unspent points. From attacks. Thank you. close. Cold resistance seriously needs to go. This thing is big.
So close. A word of advice. Don't ask her about the Diamond Matrons. You'll regret it.
Can I help you? Stay safe, traveler.
May I tear a smile upon you? Greetings.
Return to the Shining. Quite a distance back. Oh, I actually did not see that coming. Okay. Dungeon again. Can't do anything about the dungeon because I do not have any keys. Any chests here? No chests.
Thank you.
Oh, that's big. Go there now. First go up top, make sure I've cleared everything.
May I tear a smile upon you?
Thank you.
you? Stay safe, traveler. Can I help you?
Okay, thank you for watching. I'll be streaming again tomorrow, more or less the same time. I'll be streaming, let's say, about 8 o'clock again, 8:30. Thank you for watching. Please follow and comment if there's anything I can improve on my streams. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful night.